Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to get data from active workbook sets, not from table or range using Power Query. From table or range, it's super easy to get the data in Power Query. You can just right click on the table and then load it in the Power Query editor, right? But in case of sets and you don't want to convert these sets into a table, then this video will be really, really useful for you. In this example, you can see I have four different sets, you know, bars, crackers, cookies, and snacks data, and they are not tables, and I'm not allowed to convert these into a tables. So let's say these data are coming from some exports and they want to keep this as a not table, just a normal range. And if we want to get this data into Power Query, and if we try to go to this data, get data from table and range, then it says create table, right? We need to create the table, and I don't want to do that. I want to keep as is. And in this video, I'm going to show you how can we do that and how can you get data from all of these four sets and dump that in the setting sets. So we need to ignore the setting set as well, so it's not accumulating the data again and again, right? I have recorded another video to get the file path or folder path for a particular file using formula. I would suggest you to watch that. So basically, this is the formula. This is giving me the folder path, workbook name, and this is the active seat name. And I'm going to use this, and then I'm going to create two different things. Okay, one is that file path with fully qualified folder path for this particular workbook. For that, I can just use this index, this one, found 1, 2. This is going to give me the actual folder path for this particular workbook, right? I can just name this as a file path. And now I need to know the active seat name. For that, I can just use index, and that is this one, and then 1, 3. You can just replace this B3 pound with the formula that we have in this B3 cell, okay, if you want. So this is the active seat name. Now we can just grab this data from table and range, and it will get the data from the name range. And you can see that it's getting the data from the name range, that is the file path, right? Now we can just use column 1 and then 0 to get the actual file path, right? And what you need to do, if you look into this excel.currentworkbook, okay, and if you use this, you can see it's just showing me this active seat name and file path. It's not showing the seat name as a row, and we cannot get the data from that. But if we use this excel.workbook, and now it's expecting that as a binary, the first parameter as a binary. And if I use file.contents, and if I just refer that source step, now if you just press enter, now you can see it's giving me the seat options as well, along with the name range, right? So you can see it's giving me that seats information. So I can just filter this, and then I can just keep this as a sheet. And this is really, really weird because we have only one input and it's just putting true. So let's do that manually. So sheet, right? So we have these seats. Now I need to remove the active seat name, right? So if you look into this, then it says file path, but if I just specify this in another step, let me do that again. And if I just provide this active seat name, I think that will give me the active seat name, right? So this is my active seat name. And if I just move this up, now we have this filter rows, it's referencing that. So let me just change this to custom one. Okay, now it's filtering this kind equals to seat. Now we can add another filter that the item name, or you can just use the name or item. The name should be whatever we have in this active seat name, right? So let's do that. And name is not equals to active seat name. Now you can see it's removed the active seat name as well. Now we have data from all of those four different seats now in this column. So you can just remove other columns. We can just add another step that will promote these headers, right? So we can just say table dot transform rows each data, and we can just use promote headers, right? You can see, and this will give me the list, and I can just use table dot combine, and that's it. Now it's accumulating all the data from the active workbook and ignoring the active seat. And I can just load this data to existing worksheet. and then boom, yeah, 244 rows loaded from all of these four seats. And now if I just refresh, it will have those 244 rows again, because we are ignoring the data from this setting seat. So that's how, if you need to grab data from different seats, not from table or name range, in Power Query from the Active Workbook, then this is a really, really the nice way to go. And I think this is the only way you can get the data from the seats from Active Workbook. Let me know if you have any question or suggestion. Have a good day.